Thor, the god of thunder, had won the mighty hammer Mjolnir as a gift, thanks to Loki's prank. With this hammer, Thor defended the kingdom of Asgard, tackling any sort of threat. But one day after waking up, Thor sensed that his hammer was missing. The god looked for Mjolnir in his room and only found a message which said, "If you want to recover your beloved hammer, visit me in my domains so that we can negotiate. You will get it back in exchange for an appropriate ransom. Signed, Thrym." Thor knew that nobody was a better negotiator than Loki, the god of mischief, and therefore he asked him to go to Thrym's meeting in the land of giants. Loki arrived at Thrym's palace in Jotunheimr, and facing the giant, Loki began the negotiations.
"Dear Thor, come closer, because my sight is not as good as in the past. You're now slimmer than the last time we met."
Loki noticed that the giant's sight was indeed impaired, because the differences between him and the god of thunder were enormous. After negotiating, the god returned to Asgard with Thrym's proposal and presented to the Aesir gods. The giant was willing to give back the hammer if Freya, the most beautiful of goddesses, was delivered to him as a wife. The gods considered the proposal outrageous, but without the hammer Mjolnir, Thor could not defend Asgard. That was when Loki had an unusual idea, to say the least.
"Thor, I need you to wear this."
It was a wedding dress.
"How dare you insult me this way?"
"Calm down, calm down. I will explain my plan later."
Loki knew that the giant's sight was as good as a mole's, and so he wanted to take Thor to Thrym's palace disguised as the goddess Freya. Thor, without another alternative, dressed as a bride and went with Loki, also disguised as a servant of goddess Freya. When they arrived in Jotunheim, the ladies were very well received.
"Welcome to my palace. I prepared a banquet in honor of the beautiful goddess."
The giant would have to be deeply short-sighted, to the point of confusing the bulky god, dressed as a bride, with a beautiful maiden. Soon after taking his seat at the banquet table, Thor began to voraciously devour everything in front of him.
"Wow, such a voracious appetite you have, my new wife. I have never seen a goddess as gluttonous as you are."
Then Loki said,
"I think she wants to finish the banquet as soon as possible, so that you can consummate your union."
Thor furiously looked at Loki, who appeared to find the situation quite whimsical.
"Let's do it then. Bring the hammer, and we will seal this agreement and get things settled."
One of the giant's lackeys brought the hammer and placed it in front of the bride. Thor grabbed the hammer, and so he could finally unleash all of his rage. The god of thunder smashed all the giant's lackeys with his hammer, and Thrym had his head open like a melon.
"Let's go home, Loki. I can't wait to get this damn dress off of me."
"Don't you know that a good widow must wear black?"
With the return of Thor and his hammer Mjolnir, the kingdom of Asgard was safe again. And the gods never stopped to have fun at the Valhalla banquets, telling the story of when Thor dressed like a bride